Yo, what's going on guys, Tanmay here for Simple Snippets and welcome back to the 18th video tutorial of the web development course wherein we are using Bootstrap, HTML, JavaScript, CSS to make a complete portfolio website from the scratch. And in this video tutorial, we are going to be understanding how you can make that website live, that is hosted on a server. So we'll first understand what is web hosting and how you can make a website live, and we'll understand what are the things required for making your website live and some terms around web hosting. So if you've been following this entire playlist, we've already developed our complete portfolio website. So this is the 18th video tutorial in this playlist. And if you've missed any of the video tutorials, I will drop a link to the entire playlist in the video description. And you can also see a card on the top right corner. So you can go check out the entire tutorial series. If you are just here to understand what is web hosting and how to make a website live, that's pretty cool enough. In this video, we're going to be theoretically understanding what exactly is web hosting and what are the things required. If you think that web hosting is difficult and if you're confused about how to go about making a website live and you think that it is a difficult thing, then don't worry guys, this is a very simple process and by the end of this video, you'll understand everything, at least at a theoretical level, and the things required to perform web hosting and to make the website live. So with that being said, let's try to first answer what is web hosting. So starting off, web hosting is a service that allows organizations and individuals to post or host a website or web page onto the internet. So basically web hosting is a service which is provided by a service provider, so we'll come to that, but that enables organizations and individuals to post a website or any digital content actually, but since we are talking about websites right now, it enables users to put website online onto the internet. So currently here the organization or individual is us and we want our portfolio website, which is currently only existing on my system, to be put on the internet, so we need to use a web hosting service. So a web host or a web hosting service provider is the person or organization or business that provides this service, and that business provides the technologies, that is all the different things, different services, different technical requirements that are needed for the website or web page to be viewed on the internet. So websites, when it comes to making live, are hosted or stored on special computers called servers. So we'll talk about servers in a minute in detail as we move ahead, but essentially they are high performance computers which are connected to the internet, and that's where we actually host or put all our web pages, all our files. Okay, so when the internet user wants to view your website, all they need to do is type in the website address, which is basically the URL, for example facebook.com, google.com or whatever the domain name is, into the browser, and then their computer will then connect to your server where your web pages are hosted, and it will be delivered to you through the browser. Okay, so that's how it looks like, a very basic general example. And when it comes to web hosting, it's not just about providing you server space on the internet. Let's say your website is a dynamic website which has a database also in the backend, right? So if I have a database right now onto my system, obviously you cannot access it because it is not live, right? So you have to make that database also live. So that database services are also provided by web hosting service provider. Then there are some file transfer services wherein which enable you to transfer files from your system to the server. We have email services, for example. We have our live website simplesnippets.tech, right? So what if I want an email address which is something like tanmaysakpal@simplesnippets.tech? So that kind of email service is also provided by my web hosting service provider. We have some web build tools which enable us to build a website on the go. We have backup services. So let's say our server is down and some issue has happened. There's some virus or some problem is going on. So you can have backup services also. Then we have security services. Obviously servers need to be secure and protect themselves from virus and hacking problems. So typically servers are Linux based, so there is an operating system. Obviously, as I mentioned, servers are nothing but computers, right? So there has to be some operating system which operates those servers. Typically Linux is very secured, so that is preferred. And then there are different services. These are just some examples which we are not going to get into a lot of detail right now because we don't need them, but this is what is basically web hosting. So it is a service which is provided by a business, typically known as web hosting service provider. Now let's understand what exactly is a server, because onto the server is where we are going to be storing our web pages, web files, images and all the other resources, right? So what is exactly a server? So as I mentioned, in simple words, a server is nothing but a high speed computer. So just like our laptops or desktops, it also has RAM, it also has memory, it also has storage and all the other peripherals, just that this is a very high speed computer, which means that the RAM size is more, the CPU speed is very high, the data transfer speed is also very high and so on and so forth. But the difference is it is connected to the internet or some network. So servers, as I mentioned, have high performance, usually are online 24/7, because obviously you can visit Facebook anytime in the day, right? You can visit it at 3 a.m. in the night or 12 p.m. in the noon or anytime, but Facebook is going to load, Google is going to load, because those servers are up online, usually stacked up in data centers. So data centers are the locations which provide the controlled environment for servers. For example, obviously Facebook web pages are not there on your system, right? There is some server which is having all those web pages. So those web pages are stored on servers, and these servers are very high performance. So what happens is there is a lot of energy requirement, a lot of heat is generated from these servers, and to keep them running throughout 24/7 online, data centers, that is huge facilities, are maintained, and these servers are maintained inside that for a controlled environment. So proper maintenance, high energy, continuous energy, cooling systems are all implemented in those data centers. So now that we've understood what is web hosting and what are servers at a very general level, what are the important things that we need to host our website online? So there are two important things for web hosting, aka making your website live. So the first thing is web hosting space, that is the server space. So since this server is maintained in a data center, it can be anywhere in the world and it is connected to the internet, we need some space, for example 10 GB, 50 GB or whatever size of your website, we need that kind of space to store our web pages, right? So this is nothing but a server space provided by the web hosting provider, where you will store all your website files, web pages, images and other resources. Now the second thing that is needed is a domain name. So domain name is your website name, and basically in the digital world, it is an address where internet users can access your website. So this is a little bit of networking concept, data communications and networking concept. So basically when you type in google.com, there is an IP address which is mapped behind by, I guess, the ARP address resolution protocol, and then the domain name server, that is DNS, looks up for that location of that IP address and then transfers that request ahead. Now I'm not going to get into a lot of details. If you're a computer science or IT student, you definitely must have gone through this protocols in networking and data communications. But the bottom line is you require this domain name, which will point to exactly where is your server and where exactly are the web pages onto that server. Okay, so that is very important. So two major things: web hosting space and domain name. Pretty much clear now. Let's move ahead. Now, depending upon the server specifications, we have different type of web hosting. So when it comes to server specifications, the three basic ones are the shared hosting, virtual private servers, and dedicated hosting. And then there are different variants also. We have cloud hosting, we have managed hosting and whatnot. But what exactly is this in a very basic term is, when you talk about shared hosting, there is one server, and then let's say that server space has 10 GB, okay? Let's say the storage or memory space on that server is 10 GB. So when you're talking about shared hosting, that service provider is gonna split that size into multiple chunks. So 10 GB might be divided into 5 parts of 2 GB each, and you will be provided 2 GB, some other customer will be provided 2 GB, and so on and so forth. So using one server, you're distributing server space to 5 customers, right? So that becomes very cheap. But at the same time, since there is only one server, the CPU space, the RAM and the processing is divided into 5 different customers. So if there are 5 different websites, the speed of loading the server, that is the speed of processing request by that server, is going to be split into 5 different parts. So obviously the speed is going to be reduced, right? Similar to that, we have virtual private servers. So in this case, we are using the same server, that is only single server, but we are creating virtual private servers in that one single server, kind of like the way we use virtual OS, right? We load virtual operating systems into one single system. So this virtual private server is also that same concept. Underlying physical server is going to be single, but inside that, using software, we are creating multiple software based servers. Then the third type is dedicated hosting. So when you're talking about dedicated hosting, you are assigned a one complete server. So you can use it extensively, and then it is specifically used when your website is going to get a lot of requests. For example, Facebook or Google will definitely have some dedicated kind of hosting wherein obviously millions of users are online throughout the day, right? So that kind of request handled by your shared hosting is not possible. Then we have cloud hosting, and we have other different types also, which we don't really need to get into right now. But I'm just trying to tell you that there are different types of hostings, because initially when we start off, the shared hosting is going to be the cheapest one. Okay, so let's move ahead. Now, so far we talked about this web hosting and domain service providers. So there are companies. So there are free hosting and free domain services, as well as paid hosting and paid domain services. So when you're talking about free hosting services, there is a website called 000 Web Host, which provides free hosting for a limited amount of time. And then we can also have paid hosting. So you must have heard about companies like GoDaddy, HostGator, BigRock. These are the big companies and the big names when it comes to hosting space. So what these companies have is, these companies have their own servers which are located throughout the world. There are located in US, they are located in India and different parts of the country. And then they provide these services based on, as I mentioned, dedicated VPS or shared hosting. Then we also have free domain name services, which is known as .tk. So what you get is, you get a domain name, for example, simplesnippets.tk. So you don't get .com or .in. Those come under paid services. When you're trying it out for the first time, when you're doing some testing, you can go ahead with free domain services. And obviously there are other providers also. And when it comes to paid domain name services, again, these big companies, that is GoDaddy, HostGator, BigRock, they also provide these domain names for a particular charge. Let's say we are having simplesnippets.in. So that would be costing around 500 rupees per year. So you're charged annually, and that's how things go. But yeah, this was a very overview about web hosting and domain name service providers. So two things that we need is web hosting space, and we need a domain name. And that's about it. There is no complication over here. It is not a very difficult thing. And I hope theoretically you have understood what exactly we are going to be needing. So in the next video, what we're going to do is, we'll actually use a free hosting and free domain name. And what we'll do is, we'll transfer all our web pages onto that hosting space, that is that server space. And we'll see if our website can be made live. When you're starting off, I would recommend that you try to use these free services. If your website is a very basic portfolio website, it should work. When it comes to a dynamic website, if it has PHP script, if it has ASP script, then a lot of times free hostings doesn't work. They have a lot of conditions and they have a lot of problems when it comes to running scripts on the server. But a simple portfolio website should definitely work out pretty much fine. So that's what we'll try to go about. One last thing that I wanted to show about is, let's visit GoDaddy website and we'll try to understand the different services that they provide. So just go ahead and type in GoDaddy in your Google Chrome browser and you'll get the first link. And this is the UI that you'll probably see. And if you're watching this video in future, maybe the UI will be changed, obviously. But you can just go on the hosting and you'll see web hosting, which is on sale, which is always on sale actually. If you just click on it, you can see these are some prices. So the starter pack is 99 rupees per month. And these are the things that it provides. It provides one website. So you can host one website, and that website will have a 30 GB storage space. And then we have a bandwidth, which is basically a metric used to measure how much file transfer is happening, how much your website is being loaded and used. Okay. Then we have economy, wherein you can see it is 200 rupees per month. And then you get 100 GB space. You get a business mail. So let's say your website name is simplesnippets.tech. So you can get a mail like tanmaysakpal@simplesnippets.tech, so that it looks like a very professional email. Then you'll get a free domain also, but this has to be with annual plan. Okay. Then you have deluxe and ultimate, and then you get unlimited storage, unlimited websites. In the ultimate plan, you get 2x processing power. So these are all shared hosting kind of situations, and this is all Linux servers. You can check them out. But there are Windows plans also. So as I mentioned, these servers also have some operating system running behind, right? So usually Linux servers are preferred. But if you have a website which is made in ASP, using ASP.NET technology, you can go ahead with Windows plan also. So this was web hosting. We have business hosting. We have different types of servers. As I mentioned, we have dedicated, we have VPS. So all those things also are provided by these kind of companies, big companies. You can go ahead and check out the other websites also, HostGator, BigRock. If you're curious to know, our website, that is simplesnippets.tech, is actually hosted on BigRock, I guess. And this is how our website looks like. It's a WordPress website. By the way, if you don't know this website, go check this out. I put a lot of content over here also. And yeah, this was something that I just wanted to show. In the next video, what we'll do is, we'll try to make our portfolio website live by using some free hosting and free domain. And that's it for this video, guys. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any queries about how to make your website live, put them in the comment section. I would like to answer them. If you found this video informational, do share it with your friends. And if you have understood this concept, let me know in the comments. I would really like to hear that. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.